What's up, guys? This is going to be a quick video and a brake pad check on our 2015 Forester XT. This car has 41,000 miles on it now. We're probably on our fourth year. This was originally a lease way back in 2015, and we bought it out after the lease because it was good. Overall, leasing was a terrible idea because we paid a lot for the lease, and then we still have a big loan for the second half, because we did go a 5 year to keep the payments low. Fair enough. If we'd gone 3 years, it might have been a little better. But yeah, we are still owe a lot on the Forester XT. I'd just say don't lease. It just never works out in the end, except for really people that really go portable. All right, enough of that. You might say 41,000 miles. All right, let's see what we got. First, I got to remind you of something. If you followed the FXT series, you might remember that we did put DBA, Disc Brakes Australia, front rotors and pads and rear pads on this car at one time. And I did that after putting those on my 15 WRX. Same exact parts. They just did not make a rear rotor to fit the Forester, but the WRX they did. So it was the same WRX parts. Anyway, none of that really matters. All I'm saying is that the DBAs came out a while ago, okay? So the 41,000 miles is not all on these stock pads. That's the point I'm trying to make. 41,000 miles, the DBAs, I did confirm, were in the car for 1.3 years. So take about a quarter of that mileage away. So my estimate is there's about 30,000 miles approximately on these stock pads. I think they were low last time I checked them, and I've been getting nervous with the inspection coming up. So I did decide I'm going to pull off one wheel on each side and just spot check these and see if I want to order some brake pads for them. I'd either go OEM or the Z23 pads I put on everything these days. They're exactly the same price, 70 for the set of the fronts. So let's go ahead, put the car up in the air, the SUV up in the air, and just see what these pads look like. That's all we're gonna do. All right, you guys might say, hey, you can check that without even taking off the wheel. Yeah, I could approximately, but I've already done that and I need a closer look because these were getting pretty low. So I'm gonna do one side, front rear, one at a time. Just don't have to deal with jack stands and all that. It's just as easy. Not going to be getting another car, etc. All right, guys. I went even a step further, as I just really want a really good look at these. So I just took out the two little 14s, or was it 15s? 14 millimeter bolts to get to these pads properly. Really get a good look. Look, man, this caliper's heavy. All right, let's check these out. We'll just check inner and outer one side. That'll give us a good idea. Those have more than I expected. That's probably at least half, if not more, after about 30,000 miles of use. Honestly, I guess I will not worry about replacing these yet. It's kind of a waste. I mean, there's probably a year and a half left on these things. Let's go ahead, always keep these inside to outside so you don't forget which way your clips go. Let's take out the inner and just have a look, make sure it's about the same. Little thing fell over there. So, same thing. I mean, which you want. You don't want any uneven wear or anything like that. Don't do that, don't breathe in brake dust. Okay. So that's good news. I don't need to worry about the front brakes right now. I mean, in a year I can worry about it. No sense in spending like $200 to $250 to replace all the pads. Wouldn't need rotors, but that's the front checked. Let's take a look at the rear. All right, guys, let's check out the rears. Wow, the rears are way better. They're barely, I'd say they're a third used, if that. I mean, for sure, I don't remember the OEM, but It wasn't double that, I know it. The rears look excellent. I'll just check the outer to make absolutely sure. That is a lot of pad. That's like 2 years worth of pad right there. All right, guys, so good results, I suppose. I just saved a couple $100s doing all that stuff. I'm gonna leave it alone. Also, the oil change is 2,000 or 3,000 miles away, so I'm not gonna even mess with that. It's only been 3,000 miles since the last oil change video, believe it or not. So that's it, simple brake check, longer than it needed to be, but hey, check your brakes. If you're above 36,000 miles, make sure they're doing all right. It'll all depend on use, of course, also. All right, guys, thanks for watching. See you later.